talk about our democracy, when we talk about our freedoms. The way that he sees is the MAGA Republicans are the most energized part of the Republican Party. This is an extreme threat to our democracy, to our freedom, to our rights. They just don't respect the rule of law. You heard that from the president. They are pursuing an agenda that takes away people's rights.
Dark Brandon on a roll. Mm-hmm. Big speech tonight. And what better person to talk to on big speech night than... Hi, Karl Frisch. Hi, good morning.
Hi. I just need 1 minute. I've got all these top secret documents sprinkled all over my floor.
Sure.
And I haven't had time to clean them up. So if you just give me a moment.
We'll wait here.
FBI is so messy.
Thank you.
Can I just say, I'm just reading again. Trump doubled down on one of his familiar defenses for why the FBI found classified documents at his awful, crappy hotel, claiming on True Social he had already declassified the documents. Former prosecutor Renato Mariotti said the DOJ has already debunked this notion. DOJ notes that Trump's attorney and the custodian there did not assert privilege or claim Trump declassified the documents, and the lawyer signed a certification, see below, that all the documents were provided. They're in kind of a big load of hurt, aren't they?
Yeah, also, some of these documents
he really truly seems effed this time. What's that?
Some of these documents you're not allowed to have regardless. And as has been pointed out many, many, many times, they admitted they had these documents before they said they were planted, before they said that he had declassified them. So I think they're in a world of hurt.
Yeah. Was it you that said it's like Trump's a kid playing a game, that he's just safe, I'm safe? Like, it's just he's making up new rules, right? I declassified.
It's like Trump is golfing like a Trump as an adult.
Exactly.
Yes, exactly. And this new story from the Times, Trump's lawyers may become witnesses or targets in the documents investigation. So, I mean, that's going to be what's next, right? Are they going to say, he told me to do this, or he told me this was all the documents, or, you know, what happens now? So they have to testify against them.
One of his attorneys was on television and seemed to know quite a bit about the documents before the FBI got there. So... I think there's probably reason to believe that the attorneys knew that these documents were there.
Right, right. So we'll see. I don't know. What do you think is going to happen today? I mean, it's hard because it's a Trump-appointed judge, so you never know, right?
That's the question. I don't know. I mean, I would hope that things will continue moving in the direction that they're going, but there's always appeals.
Yeah. Yeah, of course. This has been his whole life, right? Mm-hmm. Delay, 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 delay the inevitable. So this was an earthquake in Alaska, last night, wasn't it?
Yeah, I was watching it from my house.
Were you? That's funny. You got to that joke first, and you're a good boy. Okay.
You betcha.
You betcha. But it is a big deal, isn't it? It's a BFD.
Well, you know, when Putin is up there and he's doing what Putin does and the jokes just keep going,
write themselves.
Right? I mean, it's like you get to go back to your satchel and take out the things from 10 years ago to use again.
Listen, we're having a going out of business sale on Rocky Mountain Mike, Sarah Palin.
Yeah.
Maybe we should do one of them, dumb down. Which one should we do? Just we'll have a going out of business sale all morning. Oh, please, God, let her be gone from our body politic forever.
I have a feeling we've not seen the last of her. I mean, she does. Yeah. She will be on the November ballot, too.
Yeah.
Hopefully the same thing happens.
She's like the clap politically, isn't she?
Well, it'll be interesting. I wonder if either Republican will fall on their sword and tell their supporters, you must vote for the other Republican.
Yeah.
I don't see Palin having that in her, but at the same time, I don't see Begich, wanting to give Palin a congressional seat.
We were having a discussion off the before the show started. Is this a case of like Palin and Begich canceling each other out, and so that's why the Democrat won? Or
ranked choice voting.
Yeah.
So Begich voters did two things that cost Palin the election. In picking their second choice, they either said, I don't have a second choice.
Right.
Or a large enough number of those voters voted for the Democrat.
Okay.
Had to have received, I think, upwards of 70% of the second votes for Begich to win, and I think she got about 50.
Okay. Pick your favorite pageant movie. Some of us, it's miscongeniality. Yeah. Yours is
Drop Dead Gorgeous.
Drop Dead Gorgeous, yeah. But she was on the Exploding Swan yesterday.
That's a good metaphor for her. And